Over 3,000 people living in 1,000 homesteads affected by the land-related crisis in the Acholi region, which has resurfaced in Lamito, Noya district, and the locals have been left frustrated by unclear information regarding the acquisition of their land. Achelam Charles, who has been through all the Ugandan governments, says this is a customary land which was first grabbed by the former president Idi Amin.
Amin was overthrown, people came back and they resumed their duty in their own customary land there. Then today we are again shocked hearing that this government of today wanted again to grab this land.
It's not clear. Others say people will be compensated, but others are saying government land cannot be compensated. According to the LC1, this place has fertile land and is densely populated.
Being in a portion of household, I can say more than even 1,000 household. And the population that is staying in the area whereby government is saying that is belonging to them is more than even 3,000 people.
Last year, the president launched a rice production farm owned by Fall Logistics Uganda Limited. However, little is known about the success of the farm.
What the people say, the land that used to be where they used to farm in Asgrove Farm was less than about 1,000 acres of land. Not this. So maybe this is just the general land grabbing which is going around also where they now expand. As long as they hear a government drop of land somewhere, they expand it to chase people.
The locals who claim that this land was initially a customary land used by residents as a group farmland between 1968 to 1973 when former President Idi Amin forcibly turned it into a state farm. The latest land uncertainty in Lamiton follows similar situation in Apar, Lakong, Atsua Ranch and other less mentioned areas in the Acholi sub-region. Report by Joseph Omagor for Urban TV.